Good morning.
Afternoon.
Well, it's actually afternoon. Yeah. So we are back here at Cameron Park. Let's go to the other side. We are actually
at North End.
Lover's Leap at the very top.
The star or the yellow star.
And we haven't decided how far we're going to hike today. But we are going to start out where are we at here? Oh, okay, we're here at Lover's Leap. So we're gonna start out by taking Baseball to Outback, Powder Monkey, and around. And here we'll decide whether we're going to do Weber Run, which is all of this. That's where we'll decide how far we're going to go today.
Whether it's 2 miles or three.
Yeah, we were going to do five, but it's a little chilly today.
A little chilly, and that river trail still flooded, so.
Yeah, and that's normally how we make it a loop, is by coming back the river trail. Plus, we have a lot to get done this afternoon. Craig leaves for travel again tomorrow.
Yep.
So, we just figured we'd get a Sunday afternoon stroll in. And go from there. I might should have gotten my jacket, but I'll be okay, I think.
That will probably determine how long our hike is.
Probably. I do have gloves and a beanie, but I don't want to get too hot.
I heard the blinkers on, I heard we're changing lanes, I heard he likes to race. I heard there's six or seven words he likes to use.
The cool thing about Cameron Park is, as we've said before, it's like 20 miles of trails, but you can mix and match them and intertwine the trails. You can intertwine the trails.
I'm hiking today with Elmer Fudd.
You can intertwine the trails as much or as little as you want to.
I think you said intertwine then.
Mm-mm.
Intertwine the trails.
Nope.
I think you did.
Nope. He's trying to make me second guess myself. It's not gonna work.
You're always in bad taste. And I heard that Monday's just a word we say every seven times around. And then we pin the tail on Tuesday, watch those strings go up and down. And the elephant in the room begins to dance, the camera zoom into his mouth begins to move. Those hateful words he uses. I don't care for your paranoid, us against them walls. I don't care for your careless. Me first, gimme appetite at all. In my mind is for sale, it's all been subdivided. Divided into reasons why my two opposing thoughts at once are fine. And the residue from the price tag on the tip of my tongue, words don't come, they go. How many likes I gotta get? For I know the truth, and the truth is season three will be a great reason to forget all about. Reality's a slippery slope. Watch the TV scream and shout. I don't care for your paranoia, us against them fearful kind of walls. I don't care for your careless. Me first, gimme.
This trail is one of the more popular with mountain bikers because it's not quite as rocky as some of the other trails. I would say it'd still be challenging, though.
On a mountain bike?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd agree.
I think this is where Craig's hit a few trees.
No. This is where Craig hit a rock. And had a goose egg on my shin about an inch tall. And I said, you know what? I'm too old for this. So I started mountain biking on flatter ground.
Yeah. It's an old well here. You're welcome.
Just one more.
You're welcome. I really can't say enough good things about Cameron Park. We absolutely love it. It's a great workout place, a great family place during the afternoon. It's very peaceful. Now, we have never technically come across anything sketchy, but we hear things.
Yeah.
So you do have to be mindful.
I don't think you ever have to worry about anything happening to you out here on the trail, but when you get up around the restrooms and parking areas, you need to be careful, pay attention to your surroundings, know what's going on.
And the rule of thumb too is to make sure you're not here after dark.
And don't come alone.
And don't come alone. Now, last year, don't know how true it is, but we heard about a couple of different incidences where women were attacked coming out of the bathrooms. Heard of one incident where a woman was running on the trail and a guy on a bike came by and knocked her down and stole her phone. So if it's true, things do happen, so you just have to be careful. But I don't come by myself. Craig does sometimes, and I mean, it can happen to a guy too, but it's a little less likely for him to mess with a big guy as opposed to a female. So you just have to be a little careful, as with anywhere you go these days. But other than that, I mean, we love this place.
Yes, and it really is a cool place.
It is.
We can't go from family oriented through all of that and come out with balance. But it really, you just need to be aware of your surroundings.
Yeah.
Like anywhere else you go, it is a really cool place.
Now, and I just want to add before I end this little, whatever you call it, tirade. On the weekends, Saturday and Sunday, there is a lot, usually. Today's kind of chilly, so it's not as many people out. But there's a lot of activity, so I wouldn't expect anything to happen then. And there's a lot of people out with kids, and you can bring your dogs out. But it's late evening, and when there's not a lot of traffic, that you have to be most careful. Anyway, that's it. It's a beautiful place. If you live in the area, it's definitely something you should take advantage of. It's a resource that's here for everyone.
On, I heard we're changing lanes. I heard we need more space. I heard that 6 or 7 words are in bad taste. It's absurd to believe that we might deserve anything, as if it's balanced in the end and the good guys always win. I don't care for your paranoia, us against them fearful kind of walls. I don't care for your careless. Me first, gimme appetite, with the residue from the price tag on those two opposing thoughts in my mind. Us against them fearful kind of walls.
So we're gonna go for the three instead of just two. If we go that way, we come out, finish Powder Monkey, but we're gonna do Weber Run, which I hate, just so you know. It feels like it's all uphill.
It's because it is. Both ways.
Yeah. But it's a very good workout.
I'm just surprised it ain't snowing and we're barefoot.
Right. This one will definitely get your heart rate up. They're gonna have to do some new maps. They're gonna officially name all these that the mountain bikers have made. Oh, wow.
Oh, cool.
This is new. Since the last time we did Weber Run. You can even still smell it.
Yep.
The wood.
To me.
Somebody's got some serious time on their hands. Let's check this out.
I'm like damn sure there ain't no freaking spikes over somewhere.
Okay, Craig thinks there might be a booby trap. So, we're going to be careful. But check it out. They got a little community here. This took some time.
This is probably somebody's kids over here playing while they built the back wall.
That's possible. Either way, that took some time to build. Oh, look, and that says one way, do not enter.
Yeah.
I just told Craig, these mountain bikers try to take this park over, we're gonna have a protest. Ain't happening. We'll share, but we ain't gonna be drove out. Just kidding. Just kidding. But we really won't be drove out.
Right. Got another one. Just two.
They sure aren't slowing down today. Usually they'll slow down a little bit when they come upon a hiker.
Yeah.
But
bikers versus hiker trash. It's always, always there.
Well, and the other thing is, like we said when we started, Outback, Powder Monkey, Weber Run are really popular with mountain bikers. So I'm sure they feel a little bit of ownership on these trails.
They probably are the only ones maintaining them.
Probably.
We're just out here hiking.
Yeah. But anyway. But they have all been polite and said thank you. So, well, most of them. Anyway. Because believe me, if I hear a bike coming, I'm getting out of the way. Momentum alone is enough to warrant getting off the trail. Oh, it's a beautiful day. Like 50 degrees today. And I have a sweatshirt on and I'm sweating.
Thank you.
about to go down Colorado, but yes, we are.
Yeah, okay. I guess we're going to go down Colorado.
But here's another little town.
What's the sign say? Farmers friends only.
This is a little more pre-manufactured than the other one. But check out the plants they've planted, because those aren't normally out here.
Yep.
Interesting. And what is this? What is this?
Yep.
It's a little bit freaky. What does it say? Fall in, all in? Huh. Secret society.
Yep.
Where did you think we were going? Alright, so now we're going down Colorado, and I will tell you, this one is booger to go up. It is either straight up or straight down. The entire way. Luckily today we're going straight down. It's a little hard on the ankles though. And the bikes have kind of changed the trail a little bit. Because it literally used to go through right there where they've got all that stacked up, because they don't want you to go through there anymore. And it used to go straight through there. But as you can see, they've changed it to where you're banking. That's the bottom of Colorado. Oh, that's full of water. I'm glad we didn't decide to go on that trail, because we'd probably get our feet wet.
I wouldn't, I'm wearing Gore-Tex.
Whatever. And now, to finish our loop, we're going to do baseball.
Now, we've hiked this trail enough to know, or this loop, this route, we've hiked it enough to know that this is exactly 3 miles.
Yep.
Start to finish, so. Almost perfect workout.
And that was baseball, which
we're still on.
I didn't show you all of it. It'll definitely get your heart rate up.
There's a lot of them out here that do that. This 100-foot elevation change and pretty quick. So.
And if you're trying to do it as a workout, you're going to go a little faster.
Yep.
Whew.
So if you live in Waco area, Cameron Park's a great place to work out, get in better shape, physical condition.
Or if you're coming through Waco,
yep,
it's a great stop to get some nature in.
Absolutely.
Whew. Great hike, babe.
Great hike. See you on the trail.
Oh, baby, I love your madness. It's so incredibly beautiful. Pandemonium. Life is so easy. Whoa, you love me to pieces. Yeah, I need it. Want you pandemonium.